To submit a new project for review by the UC Davis IRB, start by going to irbnet.org. If you're a new user, click New User Registration to create an IRBNet account. If you've already created an IRBNet account, enter your username and password to log into the system. You'll be taken to the My Projects page. This page shows a list of any projects which are currently shared with you. If you'll be working on a project which has already been started, click the study title to resume working on it. If you're going to be starting a new project, click Create New Project. Enter basic study information such as the title, PI's first name, last name, and degrees, and the sponsor for your research. If you do not have a sponsor, you can use the word departmental. The keywords and internal reference number are not required fields. Click Continue. You're taken to the Designer page. Step one of the Designer is a library of guidance documents, forms, and templates. Step two is the area where you upload study documents. On the left-hand side, you can see a menu of options. Project Overview allows you to look at basic study information. Designer contains the library and the document upload fields. Share This Project allows you to grant access to others. All principal investigators, co-principal investigators, and faculty advisors must have access to their projects in IRBNet. Please be sure to share the study appropriately before submitting to the IRB to avoid delays in the review. IRB Administration uses IRBNet to correspond with researchers, so it is required that all researchers have access to their studies. Sign This Package is used to electronically sign the submission. Principal investigators are required to use the electronic Sign This Package feature in IRBNet when submitting the initial review application. Department chairs, faculty advisors, and deans may also use the Sign This Package function if they choose. HRP 226 is required for all new application. This is our administrative approval form. If department chairs, faculty advisors, or deans wish to use the electronic signature feature in IRBNet, please make sure to type the words "See electronic signature" on the signature line of HRP 226 and upload it into the Designer. The signatory can then apply their electronic signature in IRBNet and the package can be submitted. Submit This Package is used to submit to the UC Davis IRB. Delete This Package will permanently remove anything you have uploaded into this submission. Once a package has been submitted to the IRB, it cannot be deleted. Send Project Mail is used for all correspondence with IRB Administration. Please note, you cannot send emails from your work or personal email to IRB Administration about your projects. You must use Send Project Mail. You also cannot hit reply to emails that you have received from IRB Administration. If you've received an email from IRB Administration, log into IRBNet and click Send Project Mail when replying. Project history shows a list of all submissions for this study. In this case, we just have one package, and it is currently a work in progress because we have not submitted to the IRB yet. Messages and alerts is a list of all correspondence associated with this protocol. At this time, there are no messages and alerts. To begin building our application for the IRB, click Designer. In step one, the IRBNet User Manual Initial Review Application is the first document in the library. Download this document and save it to your computer. I'm now going to minimize my IRBNet screen so that I can find my guidance document. I open the guidance document and expand to show the bookmarks. These bookmarks are screen-by-screen guidance on how to complete the online initial review application. If I've already started my application and I only need guidance on a certain question, I can jump to the page which I'm currently working on. For example, research location information, which doesn't have much instruction in the online form, has several specific elements which are required for IRB review. So please make sure to review the guidance document when completing your online form to make sure you've provided all the necessary information. I'm now going to minimize my guidance document and go back into IRBNet to continue working on my application. I'm in the designer screen, and I scroll to the bottom of the page and click Add New Document. The attached document page has two options. The top section is a manual upload where you can upload documents which you've worked on outside of IRBNet and save to your computer. The lower section is an online document section. This is where we'll find our online application for initial review. Use the drop-down to select UC Davis Initial Review Application and click Add. If I have a study which has previously used the online application, I can clone one of my existing studies. When I select Clone an Existing Wizard, a list of my current studies comes up. I select the study I wish to clone and click Continue. If I do not wish to clone any of my wizards, I can click Create a New Wizard from Scratch, and I will be taken to the General Instructions page. If I do not have any existing wizards, I will not see this page, and I will be taken directly to the General Instructions page. For this example, I'm going to clone one of my existing wizards. The system is now pulling all of the information from my previous application into this study. I'm taken to the General Instructions page. I can use the Jump To button to select any pages I wish to edit, or I can click Next to begin working through the application. If I did not clone a study and I'm creating a new one from scratch, I will not have any options in the Jump To section, and I must select Next to begin completing my application. I now start providing information in my application. In this case, the information has been pulled from my previous application, and I just need to update any changes to the information. The PI department field is a drop-down. If I cannot find my PI's department, I can select Other and type the department name in the PI department Other field. When I've provided all the information, I click Next. Every time I click Next, the document saves. The next question is there a co-principal investigator? A co-principal investigator is required for all clinical trials. If I answer yes, then the form will ask me questions about the co-PI. If I answer no, the form will skip the co-PI questions and move to the next topic. I continue moving through this application, answering each question until I reach the PI assurance. It's important the PIs are aware of this statement. Please make sure that you review this information with the PI prior to submitting this application. Once I select yes and click next, I'm taken to the form complete page. This page provides a list of documents which must be submitted along with my application. All new studies require HRP 226 administrative approval form, either HRP 503 protocol template or a sponsor protocol. If you have a sponsor protocol, you are not required to submit HRP 503 protocol template. Any questionnaire, surveys, or interview questions, as well as any subject-facing materials such as recruitment documents. At any time while I'm completing my form, I can click Save and Exit. All of my work will be saved. Then to enter the form and resume working or make edits, I click the pencil icon. I can now use the Jump To section to select a page I wish to edit. Update my information and select Next. Once done, I select Save and Exit. I can view my answers in a document format by clicking the paper icon. This is a PDF of the answers I have provided. This is the document the IRB will review when they look at my application. I now need to upload my additional study documents. According to my form complete page, I must upload HRP 226, either HRP 503 protocol template or a sponsor protocol, and any surveys, questionnaires, or interviews. I can use the drop-down from the library to download blank versions of these documents. HRP 226 administrative approval form, and HRP 503. I find in the library that there are several versions of HRP 503. Several of these have been specialized for use in certain types of research. Number 2 is a generic version. Number 3 is for use when doing record, data, or specimen review. For example, a medical chart review. The 4th document is for use when doing surveys, interviews, or focus group research. Download the appropriate HRP 503. Save it to your computer. Complete the document, and when you're ready, upload it into IRBNet to submit to the IRB. I've now completed my documents outside of the system, and I'm ready to add them to IRBNet. I click Add New Document. There is a guidance document in the library which will tell you which document type to select. In this case, I'm uploading HRP 226, an application form. I provide a description of the document, select Browse, locate the file I wish to upload, select Open, and Attach. HRP 226 is now uploaded into IRBNet. I can do the same process for HRP 503. I select Protocol, provide a description of the document, click Browse, locate the file I wish to upload, and click Attach. I've now uploaded HRP 503. If I need to upload a new version of the document because I've made changes, I click the pencil icon, which allows me to browse and locate a new version of the document. I've now updated my HRP 503 with a new version. At any time while I'm building my protocol, I can share this project with others for their review or so they can access my study documents. I do this by clicking Share This Project. I click the blue Share, The system defaults to UC Davis, so I click Select Organization. I can use the search field to find others with whom I wish to share the study. I select the appropriate level of access. All principal investigators must have full access to all of their studies. I select Save. Now that I've shared this study with the necessary personnel, and I've uploaded and completed all of my study documents, I'm ready to sign this package. I click Sign This Package and use the drop-down to select my role. In this case, I'm the principal investigator. I click Sign. The system asks me to validate my login information. I click Continue. My signature has now been applied to this package. Please note that UC Davis does not accept the designee signature mode. The PI must sign off on all initial submissions. Other signatories which are required are the department chair, and if applicable, the faculty advisor, and the dean of the school. These people may use the Sign This Package feature of IRBNet, or they may opt to physically sign the form. If they choose to physically sign the form, print it, have them sign it, scan it, and then upload it into the designer using the same process we use to upload other study documents. If they choose to electronically sign, please check with them to find their process to notify when a study is ready for signature. Once all signatures have been collected, the study is ready to submit. I click Submit This Package. The system defaults to UC Davis, and I select Continue. I use the drop-down to select the appropriate submission type. In this case, it's a new project. I provide any comments necessary for the review of my study and click Submit. Once submitted, this package is locked. It will be handled by IRB Administration, and they will correspond with me about next steps.